Pilots are always told to fly by attitudes. But what are an aeroplane's attitude, and what are the characteristics of the various attitudes? Well, before we answer these questions, I will define aeroplane attitudes. These are very important definitions because the attitudes are used to manage the flight path, while the flight controls are only used to manipulate the attitudes, and the engine power is only used to alter the energy state of the aeroplane. So, welcome to Professional Pilot Training. My name is Robert Loretan, I am the Chief Flying Instructor of PPT. The understanding of an aeroplane's attitude is critical to precisely controlling an aeroplane's flight path. In subsequent presentations, I will explain the functions of the various aeroplane attitudes. However, in this presentation, I will only define aeroplane attitudes. At professional pilot training, an aeroplane's attitude is defined as the alignment of an axis to the vertical, horizontal, or relative airflow. This is an aeroplane's longitudinal axis. This is an aeroplane's lateral axis. The azimuth, or horizontal plane, is visible as the horizon. It is horizontal, or level, and at right angles to gravity, while the vertical plane is parallel to gravity. It is important to understand that when the horizon is not visible due to higher terrain between the observer and the horizon, or due to low visibility, the resulting skyline may not be horizontal. However, the horizontal plane is always at right angles to gravity. In low visibility, a pilot may need artificial instrumentation to determine the horizontal plane. The aeroplane's longitudinal axis forms two primary attitudes that control the flight path in both the vertical and the horizontal. These are known as control attitudes. The control attitudes are the vertical attitude and the heading attitude. Two supporting attitudes control or influence the heading attitude. The heading attitude is controlled by the bank attitude and influenced by the balance attitude. I will now summarise PPT's terminology for aeroplane attitudes. There are two control attitudes, the vertical attitude and the heading attitude. The heading attitude has two supporting attitudes, the bank attitude and the balance attitude. I will now define the control attitudes individually. Firstly, the vertical attitude. And the vertical attitude is defined as the alignment of the longitudinal axis to the horizontal. It is called the vertical attitude because it determines the vertical flight path. In this diagram, the aeroplane would be climbing because the vertical attitude is above the attitude required for level flight. In this diagram, the aeroplane would be descending because the vertical attitude is below the attitude required for level flight. Remember, there are two control attitudes, the vertical attitude and the heading attitude. The azimuth attitude, or commonly known as the heading, is defined as the alignment of the longitudinal axis to a directional datum or to a ground feature. The heading is a control attitude because it determines the horizontal direction of the flight path. In this case, the aeroplane is heading 360 and towards the distant headland. In the second situation, the aeroplane is heading 040 towards the coast. The heading attitude has two supporting attitudes that are used to manage the heading. The bank attitude directly controls the heading, and the balance attitude influences the heading. The primary supporting attitude is the bank attitude, and it is defined as the alignment of the aeroplane's lateral axis to the horizontal. The bank attitude controls the direction of the aeroplane, its heading, by tilting the lift force and creating a side force that accelerates or turns the aeroplane into the direction of bank. When the bank attitude is placed parallel to the horizon, the lift force is vertical and has no side force to turn the aeroplane, so the heading remains constant, except for the influence of balance. The balance attitude is defined as the alignment of the longitudinal axis to the relative airflow. In this diagram, the aeroplane is in balance because the heading and the longitudinal axis is parallel to the relative airflow. When the longitudinal axis is across the relative airflow, the aeroplane is out of balance. It will be yawing slightly to change the heading along the line of the wings. The balance attitude is a minor supporting attitude that influences heading. When the aeroplane is out of balance, the heading is not aligned with the relative airflow, and a small side force is generated that yaws the aeroplane to change the heading. However, this side force is not large enough to accelerate the aeroplane into a turn that would bring the heading back into alignment with the relative airflow. Consequently, in an out-of-balance situation, the flight path is not directly along the heading line, and it is difficult to predict the flight path in this situation. When the flight path is parallel to the relative airflow, the aeroplane is in balance and has no side forces generated. So, in still air, the flight path is directly along the heading line as established by the bank. This document establishes definitions and terminology that forms the foundation for other topics. This material is unique to professional pilot training Coffs Harbour. To understand how to control an aeroplane, please study these additional topics: how to judge aeroplane attitudes visually, visually observing roll and bank in side-by-side seated aeroplanes, the effects of attitudes, the vertical attitude datum, the primary effects of controls, the secondary effects of controls, and energy management. In this lesson, the underpinning concepts are: A, that in controlled flight, the flight path is always controlled by the aeroplane's attitudes, and B, that the flight controls are only used to manage the attitudes, and C, that movement of the air parcel containing the aeroplane modifies the flight path. Professional Pilot Training Proprietary Limited has copyright on this material. However, copyright permissions granted by PPT are quite extensive. Professional Pilot Training gives conditional approval for all persons or organisations to copy, use, or republish this document for private or commercial use. The copyright permissions given by PPT have certain conditions. It would be a breach of the Professional Pilot Training copyright if any person or organisation alters this document in any way. In using this document, the entire publication must be used or republished, and when using or republishing this document, a statement acknowledging Professional Pilot Training as the copyright holder and author must be included. The statement must be made in such a way that all persons viewing the republished document are made aware of PPT's copyright. Aeroplane attitudes defined by Professional Pilot Training. This document is designed for all aviators, from student pilots through to airline pilots, and for any persons with an interest in aviation. There is no prerequisite knowledge or experiences required to understand this chapter. The basic definitions will be used in later lessons that explain the skill of how to manage the flight path of an aeroplane. Please enjoy our material. You'll find it's very accurate and very useful. Interested parties may contact Professional Pilot Training on any of the numbers or email addresses shown in this slide. Please feel free at any time to contact myself, Robert Loretan, or my staff and discuss any problems you've got in how to fly, and we'll be very happy to assist. That concludes this chapter on aeroplane attitudes and their definitions. Most viewers will be aware that these definitions are not normally included in pilot training. However, pilots are universally told to fly by attitudes without being given any precise guidance on what an aeroplane attitude is or what its characteristics are. In other chapters, I will explain how to judge the attitudes and what their effects are. I will also explain the effects of the flight controls that don't actually control the flight path. I suggest pilots and students should study the entire series of chapters to learn how all of these factors are used and how they fit together. Any interested pilot or member of the public should feel free to contact me to discuss the concepts involved.